그러니까 석가 사업을 한 거죠.
सबको मेरा कैमरा दिखता है यस बेटा सर थोड़ा सा अरे हाँ
On behalf of SWIA, St. Wilfrid Institute of Architecture, I would like to welcome all the esteemed dignitaries, our students, and all our guests to Wilfrid College at the convocation function for SWIA. As you are aware, that this convocation function is a combined one for three batches, 2014 to 19, 2015 to 20, and 2016 to 22. And we have a total of 96 students passing out. Though we say that the number is only 96, we are looking at a time period of 2014 to 22, a period of nearly 9 years. It's been a very long association of the student and the teachers, and their efforts of teaching and learning, which we are having today. It will be thus a historic moment for the institution. As we celebrate the glorious years of the teaching and learning journey, it's a proud moment for all of us to have this function post-pandemic, and it's all the more a reason for celebration. We feel so happy, and it's our pleasure to see all of you join us here. Thank you.
I welcome everyone and request Saju sir to escort our chief guest to the stage for lamp lighting. Today's chief guest, Mr. R.K. Jha. Please bring the candle and our chief guest of honor, Mr. Shivaji Patil and Amit Berde sir, for lamp lighting. HR ma'am also, please ma'am.
एकदन्ताय वक्रतुण्डाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय बालचन्द्राय श्रीगणेशाय धीमहि एकदन्ताय वक्रतुण्डाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय बाल गाने गानो सुखाय गान मनाय
थैंक यू गेस्ट लेट अस इनवोक लॉर्ड गणेशा एंड सीक हिज ब्लेसिंग्स बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम आफ्टर द लैंड क्लैपिंग आई रिक्वेस्ट द गणेश वंदना डांस फ्रॉम आवर स्टूडेंट्स Now we'll have Ganesh Vandana dance performance by our students. I request the guests to be seated. Sanika and group, please be on stage for the dance performance. Music, please. Thank you, students. After seeking the blessings from Lord Ganesha, we move further for our program. We have with us our esteemed dignitaries who have been kind enough to grace the occasion. And I would like to request them to be escorted to the stage by the volunteers. Gayatri, please escort our chief guest, Mr. R.K. Jha, on the stage. Our guest of honor, Mr. Amit Berde, please Gayatri, escort them on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause. Our guest of honor, Mr. Shivaji Patil, please welcome Mr. Shivaji Patil. I request our principal, Mr. Saju Cherian, to be seated on the stage too. Well, it is time now to felicitate our distinguished dignitaries. I would request our principal, Saju sir, to present a bouquet of appreciation to our chief guest, Mr. R.K. Jha. Please welcome everyone, Mr. R.K. Jha. sir, to present bouquet of appreciation to our guest of honor, Mr. Amit Berde. Chief guest, Mr. R.K. Jha. With over 50 years of professional experience in planning and development of urban and regional transportation system, city planning and development, financing and execution of large projects, our chief guest of today, Ramakant Jha, is widely traveled and has wide experience in national and international projects. Some major projects to his credit are planning and development of GIFT City, Gujarat, planning of multimodal transportation system for Navi Mumbai, Navi Mumbai Airport, Bandra Worli Sea Link, Mumbai Pune Expressway, multimodal international hub airport in Nagpur, Navi Mumbai SEZ, to name a few. Important posts he has led include MD and Group CEO GIFT of GIFT City Ahmedabad, advisor to government on smart city projects, advisor to MMRDA CIDCO. He was Chief Transportation and Communication Planner in CIDCO Navi Mumbai. Also, he has worked for as a President in NMSEZ at Reliance Industries, Senior Professor, Civil Engineering, IIT Mumbai, and there is a lot more. He was Visiting Professor of IIT Mumbai, Railway Staff College, Baroda, IIM Bangalore, and has published more than 300 technical papers at international conferences or professional journals. We welcome you, sir. Thank you for coming. Our guest of honor, Mr. Amit Berde. He currently heads the precast design group in L&T, Residential Building Business Units of Buildings and Factories, IC. Previously, He was with a leading precast concrete manufacturer in the US for about 10 years and has extensive experience in residential, commercial, and industrial precast concrete structures. Having designed and managed several precast concrete projects such as data centers, office buildings, schools, warehouses, industrial plants, stadiums, and parking structures, Mr. Amit is a member of PCI, ACI, ASC, and ASSC, a registered professional engineer and a LEED certified professional. He is graduated from Purdue University, Indiana, USA, with a master's in civil engineering. Please give a round of applause and welcome him. Our guest of honor, Mr. Shivaji Patil, I would like to brief about him too. Presently, he is an architect and project management consultant to Mumbai University, Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation, Mumbai APMC, CIDCO, and various residential and commercial projects in Mumbai, Thane, and Navi Mumbai. Shivaji Rao S. Patil, originally from Kolhapur, graduated in architecture from IIT Kharagpur in 1980 and formed Shivaji Patil and Associates in 1982 for offering architectural PMC professional services, registered with COI in 1982 and is a fellow member of IIA PATA. In last 41 years as an architect and PMC, he has designed, supervised and completed more than 350 buildings in Mumbai, Thane, Navi Mumbai, Kolhapur and Enron power projects at Guhagar in residential, commercial, industrial, educational and as well as social facilities sectors too. He is on the panel of Mumbai University, NMMC, MHADA, Mumbai, APMC, CIDCO, Member of Building Works Committee of ICT Matunga, Mumbai, Executive Committee Member, IIA, Navi Mumbai Center. I welcome you, sir. Please give a big round of applause. Which we all of us have been anxiously waiting for. Okay, before we hand over the degrees to our alumni, we will be having presentation from our guest of honor. So I welcome Mr. Amit Berde.
One very unique challenge that we took up last year, and as you have gone through the COVID challenge, this project also has gone through COVID challenge. It started right in the middle of COVID, and then we took up this large housing project for Raja, for CIDCO. Just to give you an idea of the size, it's for about 5,000 crore. So we are building about 22,000 houses, and that's probably not very unique in India, right? We have large housing demand, everybody knows. But the way the project was conceived is all those 22,000 houses were supposed to be completed in 3 years flat. So that's the demand what we are looking at. And that's where that precast technology came into picture, where we are building, it's not rapid construction anymore, it's ultra-rapid construction. We are building much faster than what we used to. So traditionally, if you want to set a benchmark, we are looking at a typical floor-to-floor cycle time. How long it takes from one floor to go to next floor in construction, that's the usual benchmark for any contractor or the owner to track the performance of the project. If you go conventional buildings, in advanced age of today also, we spend about 12 to 15 days per floor in that building, what buildings we are building. When it comes to precast, we are doing that improvement to about 7 to 8 days per floor. And then this challenge came, which we call Mission 96, which 96 flats in 96 days. And why 96 is because we have 12-story building and about 96 flats in there. So we took up that challenge saying, okay, I'm building that in 8 days, but how fast I can go? Given the best resources, how fast we can go? And we worked out the math saying, I can build each floor in 3 days itself. I don't have to wait for even 8 days or 12 days, what we are conventionally doing. So that's how that mission was conceived, that mission 96. 96 flats in 96 days. Next slide, please. Yeah. So these are actually some of the unique things that you will see. One of the biggest unique thing, you may not be able to read on screen, but each floor was completed in just 3 days. So imagine a 12-story building. We have finished that building construction in just 36 days, just about 1 month. Further, that building was finished and handed over to client in just 96 days. So that is one of the unique thing, the technology. Nowadays, we are talking about the technology. You are going to get into that world. Some of you are already working, and you will see there is an immense focus on technology, right? I was just speaking before this interaction to our guests, and there is an enhanced requirement from government, from your clients, to build faster. What used to be very slow and you are not worried, take your own time, those days are gone. You will see when you step into the professional world itself, it is an intense technology driven industry now. Conventional ways are gone. There is a lot of focus from the corporates, from the governments, to bring in that new technology. We are talking about the AI, we are talking about the ChatGPT. Things are there. So if you see this matrix itself, whatever we used to take it, we have reduced that. Our improvement is about 30, 40, 50% of the time frame. You look at the overhead water tank. Conventionally, that water tank takes at least 45 to 50 days by the time you build it, put water in it, test in it. In this project, that water tank, we put water in it in 7 days. And that's the advantage of technology and how it's done. Next slide, please. So these are the actual real photographs of that same building, right? So day zero, we are there. In literally every 3 days, we are adding up one floor there. So that's the great improvement that you will see. Next slide, please. And the technology, of course, comes with the challenges, right? You have to have lot of resources. So instead of using one crane, we put two cranes in. Instead of having the floors delivered, I mean the elements delivered from the factory, we stock the elements right there so that your cranes are building. So you have to plan. You have to get into it, get your hands dirty, and then only things will happen. Next slide, please. Finishing, right? Precast technology is only going to build the building. You still have to go inside, lay your tiles, finish it, paint it. And there was no rapid construction technology there. So there immense planning and logistic supply chain went in. So the same process, when the building was inaugurated at 96 days, we made it a point that the guest of honor climbed through the elevator and went up. Next slide, please. And lastly, the digital. And this is one of the biggest things that you are going to see the shift when you get into the industry. Right? The days of Excel are gone. We are not using Excel anymore. We are shifting to multiple platforms where as much as possible work is done through the digital ways. Now a lot of concern usually is there with the young engineers, saying if you go, now AI, ChatGPT is there, whether our job will be there or not. And what our take is, don't shy away from the technology. The technology or these digital ways are only going to give you more time to do things that you have not done before. So look at this technology as where your day-to-day typical work, which you really don't want to do, will be taken care by these technologies, so that you can think for bigger things. You can think for things that have not never been done before. Next slide, please. And very last, you are in construction. You can't escape that. All this mission, all this rapid construction, whatever that we are doing in 8 days, we did in 3 days. On day one, we had announced that your speed has no meaning without that safety and quality. So the entire project, even if we built much faster, went without any safety incidents and without any quality NCS from the client, and we have completed it through. So with that, I would like to again congratulate you all, wish you all the very best. In what my little 20 years, I have learned two things or piece of advice is, one, you build a passion, right? That passion is not going to come overnight. You may not have that passion now, but you have to have those conscious efforts, right? I did my graduation in my master's thesis. I took a precast concrete course. And at the end of that course, I went and told my professor, this is what I want to do. And last 22 years, I am in that industry. Whether I was as passionate or excited about precast in year one, I may not, or I was not. But it is constantly and consciously developed.
And then the second thing is, once you get into the industry, whether you are in construction or in design or planning, or you go to something else and do IT or AI, it doesn't matter. Get into the details. Read the drawings. Exactly know what's going on. Go through the details. Go to the site. Right? Today, before coming to this function, I have gone to the site. My shoes are dirty. You get your shoe dirty. You get your hands dirty. And then only you can deliver. So all the very best to you. And pretty excited to be here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Those were very useful insights. Going forward, we believe precast and prefab models would take precedence over all other forms of construction. And definitely, the students will mark your words too. Thank you for your presentation. Next, we move on to presentation for by Mr. Architect Shivaji Patil, sir. I request, sir, to please.
I am thankful for my brief introduction, and it's a great honor for me to be here in this convocation and degree distribution, district degree certificate distribution program at St. Wilfrid College of Architecture. It's a great privilege for me too. I'm here as a representative of Indian Institute of Architects, New Mumbai Center. And you know, it is a more than 100-year-old institution of architects. And this is for our professional, you know, professional information, knowledge sharing, and guidance. It's a very good platform for fellow architects and the teaching faculty too. At this time, I remember a convocation program. Convocation program is like a festivity where you are receiving your degree certificate after 5 years of study in college. And I remember that in my first year, there was a chief guest was Mrs. late Prime Minister Srimati Indira Gandhi. That time, she had given almost 1 hour lecture or 1 hour thundering speech on role of technology and science in the development of the nation. Today, even here, when I see the kind of festive mood, I just recall my almost 45 years back memory, and it gives me a great pleasure to say that also. Now we architects, we are governed by Architects Act 1972, which was enacted by the Parliament. And Council of Architecture is established to monitor the professional, architectural profession as well as architectural education. So it is very necessary for our better future. So we should follow all the guidelines framed by Council of Architecture. And most important part for the architects is the professional code of conduct. Unless we are disciplined in ourselves, see, the society will not respect you. We need to have follow all rules, regulations framed in by Council of Architecture. And see, architecture is not a, what you call, it's not a fast making, money making side. Lot of hard work, lot of integrity you need to have with the project. In the last 45 years of my career, I found, you know, go slow and steady, but then you should never lose your value system, your integrity with the project, and service to the society at large. Now I am presenting some of the projects which I have completed. Yeah, next slide, please. Next. This is an office building for Maharashtra State Cooperative Housing Finance Corporation. This building is basement ground and 9 upper story building. It was completed in 1 year. And that time it was inaugurated by Chief Minister Mr. Vilasrao Deshmukh and ex-Defense Minister Mr. Sharad Pawar in 2000. It's a very, you know, unique project at Bandra Kurla Complex. It's a corporate head office for Maharashtra State Cooperative Housing Finance Corporation, which was pioneer in housing finance in late 60s and 70s. And a lot of cooperative societies in Mumbai and Thane are financed by this Maharashtra State Cooperative Housing Finance Corporation. This is next slide. Next slide, please. This is Enron Power Project, a housing complex at Guwahagar. It's 96 row houses were completed there, but unfortunately, the Enron Power Project is in the doldrums because of, you know, The next slide, please. This is one big housing project at Thane. 70-acre land, and it's 100 buildings which were under construction since 1986. So this was my first project in Thane itself, and it was a great privilege to have such a big project, and it was a great experience, right, dealing from urban land selling to the municipal approval to the site supervision, working drawings, estimates. So everything is done under one roof, and it was a very pioneer project in my professional career. Next. This is part of the buildings in that complex. Next. This is some of the other buildings. This is some of the other buildings there. This is also one, some part of that project itself. This is another Devdarshan complex at Thane. This is Navadurga complex at Navi Mumbai. Then we have, this is a housing complex, come commercial complex at Kolhapur. Then this is a housing complex at Nerul Madhvi Society. Then this is Cosmopolitan Society at Nerul, 300 flats been accommodated here. Then this is the Sailesh Tower at Nerul, which is having almost 100 flats there. Then this is a Maharashtra State Cooperative Housing Society. There are 880 flats and 70 shops. It was, the whole project was completed in 18 months. We were architects and project management consultant. First of October 1993, the work started, and 31st March 1995, the project was completed. And then Chief Minister, Mr. Joshi, Manohar Joshi, had inaugurated this project for, and 880 policemen who stay in the slums, they got their own house at very reasonable cost. Plus, they generated 3 crore rupees surplus fund from the sale of the shops along the road. So it was a very pioneer project and gave me a great satisfaction for doing everything under one roof and completing the project within the estimated cost in estimated time too. This is Maharashtra Police Housing at Kandivali. Next slide, please. This is housing complex at CBD Bellapur, where 100 flats are there. It's part of that project. This is at for Bombay University, the health center, which is near the entrance gate itself of Bombay University at Kalina campus. We were architects for that. Then Rajiv Gandhi Center for Contemporary Studies and Research at Kalina Campus, Mumbai. Then next slide, please. There is an auditorium in that. It's part of that auditorium photograph. Then we are the, this is that UMDA center at Kalina campus. We were project management consultant for this project. Then this is for New Mumbai Municipal Corporation, social facility building at Vashi, sector 12, sector 14. This inauguration photographs and then we have a next slide, please. This is a fire brigade station at Koparkhani for New Mumbai Municipal Corporation. Then we have a residential building at Baikala. It's a 28-story building, which is coming, redevelopment building, which is coming up, which has almost completed at Baikala. Then the major projects under construction. No, next slide, please. This is a bus terminus come so commercial complex and swimming pool come indoor sports facility on in sector 12, Vashi. This is a very unique project which will be completed by December 2023. This is at a podium level, fourth floor podium level. You have an Olympic-sized swimming pool with all the changing rooms and stadia for around 500 people. So it is, you can have water polo matches as well as swimming competition of Olympic size, 50 meter by 25 meter size is there. So it's a very unique project and very awaited project in for by New Mumbai Municipal Corporation. This is the construction photographs, which is going on in full swing. There are around 200 people working round the clock on this building. We are architects and project management consultant. We have a full-time supervising staff at site. These are construction photographs. This is the main area where the buses, bus routes are going. There are two bus routes of 7.5 meter each. So all the bus stops are there inside. And with the cafeteria, then the control room, everything is accommodated there. Then this is another project for New Mumbai Municipal Corporation. We have done the IT complex. Next. 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 Now this is a sports complex at Gansoli, Navi Mumbai. There's a 36-acre plot which is allotted to Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation, where you have a various sports facility of international standard as per Maharashtra Sports Infrastructure Development Plan Policy 2001, where every village, every city, every district, every taluka has a taluka level sports complex, district has a district level sports complex, and region has a regional level sports complex. And this is one of the regional level Konkan region sports complex, which has been taken over by New Mumbai Municipal Corporation, and land is allotted by SIDCO. There is various facilities in that. This is an indoor stadium for all the athletic activities, a 16,000 sitting capacity. Next slide, please. This is that indoor stadium, which is internal in indoor view of the stadium. Totally 16,000 people can sit, and all the kind of athletic, indoor athletic activities and sports activities can be held. This is a totally centralized air conditioning project, having 40 entries and exit gates. And this is one of the unique projects of Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation. Then we have a sports academy, International Sports Academy. In that campus itself, there is another International Sports Academy is also been planned, giving all kind of educational facility for all sports. Next. Then we have an Olympic-sized indoor swimming pool, with a diving pool and 2,500 sitting capacity stadia. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. This is the athletic hostel, housing, accommodating around 500 gents athletics and 300 ladies athletics. Next, please. This is a commercial building. Next, please. This is that entire layout of the complex where all the, you are on the other side, we have a 75,000 capacity cricket stadium, 45,000 capacity FIFA standard football stadium with athletic tracks and athletic facilities. And all other activities have been trying to accommodate along with the 3,500 car parking. Because car parking is one of the main issues while holding the international games and competition. Then this is next, this is a cricket stadium. This is indoor view, next slide. Indoor view of the cricket stadium. Then this is, we have a FIFA standard football stadium. Then this is a Lok Kala Kendra auditorium at Gansoli. This is also one of the main project of Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation. The various views of that. This is the indoor view of the auditorium. Then this is for the APMC building, Kanda Batata Market Redevelopment Project, where we are architects. Now this is the APMC building, another complex. Thank you. This is what one of the projects, some of the projects I would just wanted to show you. So that, you know, young architects will have some kind of imagination having such a big projects in future and, you know, get inspired by such kind of a projects. I hope you all will have a great future. And from on the behalf of IIM Navi Mumbai Center, wish you all the best for your future professional as well as educational career. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Those were very useful insights, so many pointers for our future architects, the future of India. Now I request our principal Saju sir to address the audience. Please give a big round of applause.
Good afternoon to all. In this occasion, I would like to welcome our honorable chief guest, R.K. Jha sir, other guest of honor, Shivaji Patil sir, Amit Bhade sir, other faculties and other principals, then respected parents, respected ex-alumni architects, and dear students. It is great pleasure to see you all again. I extremely very happy.
चार साल से आपको पढ़ाया some of people done very good some एक दिन आ रहे दो दिन नहीं आ रहे सभी पकड़ के करवाए
then excellent. So now of all you are all qualified architects. I hope you all are doing well and also capable to take any professional challenge. See, one thing I want to inform you that I have seen many architects in market, many qualified architects. Then you think how many of them are capable to handle the professional things either in execution or academic, you think it. So you all to need to expert in your field. In my request, you specialize one subject. Architecture, a lot of specialization is there. At least one subject and try to become master in that one subject. Example, either you go design or for execution or for planning or anything. For example, our great personality APJ Abdul Kalam, he is from humble life to become the top executive of our India. He is a missile man. He specializes one subject, that is science, especially in physics. The other guy, Michael Faraday, 18th century, he invented dynamo, the industrial revolution will start. इसका वजह से अपना आर्किटेक्चर इंजीनियरिंग पॉलिटेक एंड आईटी सब दुनिया में हो गया बट उसका क्वालिफिकेशन ही पास्ड अप टू 4th स्टैंडर्ड ही स्पेशलाइज्ड इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग और अप टू द फैमिलियर फेलो फ्रैंक लॉयड राइट ही स्टार्टेड हिज करियर एज ए ड्राफ्टमैन वो किधर कौन सा लेवल तक आ गया तो हम आप लोग बिहार तक पढ़ा 5 साल बहुत सारा असाइनमेंट किया Very talented student I have seen in my batch, first to third batch. Many, many, especially first batch. I salute them. I have seen some of them, Frank Lloyd Wright, Charles Scurria, etc., etc. You prove it. So, hence you must achieve adequate skill and knowledge. इसके लिए थ्रू योर रीडिंग हैबिट रिसर्च ऑब्जर्वेशन प्रैक्टिस एक्सेट्रा अभी बिहार हुआ दैट इज ओनली अ गेट पास आप उधर जाके क्या करेगा सी इज अ वेरी कॉम्पिटिटिव वर्ल्ड अभी हमको आगे आने का पर्टिकुलर फील्ड में यू शुड हैव ए थरो नॉलेज That's why I am telling you specialize one field first and try to become master of that. You can do. You always think I can win. Wherever you are going to work, you try to, you should be a punctual, honest and practical, hardworking habit. Also, you try to finish your project on time. Say today, not tomorrow. Sometimes you are going to work in either construction industry, design, or academic. No problem. You select your own choice. But your ultimate aims to the top post. Even in construction or in design, chief architect, chief planner, MD, CEO, etc., etc. Or you are going for academic. Your intention is to become Head of department, principal, director, ultimately vice chancellor. Why not? So today onwards, you try what are the qualifications you needed and what are the material to be collected. See the three dignitaries, great dignitaries, you will get a much more inspiration from their work. They are highly qualified in different field. They have done a lot of projects. It's a great experience for you all. So I conclude my speech. I would like to wishing you all a successful career. Please take yourself and your near and dear, your parents. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.
Thank you, sir. Those were very useful insights and interesting perspective, how the campus was and how the college life was, with full of humor and anecdotes. Now, well, the time has come, students, for which you have been waiting long, and we shall start with handing over the degrees. We would like to start with the class of 19 batch. Please make some noise. Raise your hands. Please, can we have the AV, please? First, we'll be starting with the batch of 2019. Be ready. As per the names, we'll be reading out.
Ashwini Pisar.
I request our chief guest to hand over the degree to our students
भाग्यशाल होंगे
Thank you.
come?
Nehal Gerwada.
Shamuvi Saval.
Thank you.
clapping, keep clapping.
Jalgaonkar.
I request our guardians to please be on stage.
सूरज को मैं निकल गया रूबरू जो गुमशुदा सखाब था वो मिल गया यादों के पुराने एल्बम में छुपा के रखे हैं हमने वो दिन गुल्लक में बड़ी चवन्नी सी बचा के रखे है हमने वो दिन ना किसी मंजिल की फिकर थी जिंदगी जीने की उम्र थी दोस्ती और Institute of Architecture, Panvel, hereby pledge that we shall always endeavor to be scrupulously honest in the discharge of our duties, as an architect, that we shall always endeavor to utilize our knowledge of science and technology for the services of our industry, society, and glorify our institute, that we shall under all circumstances uphold the dignity
of the individual
and the integrity of the profession, that we shall in word and deeds guard against all narrow loyalties and sectarian prejudices,
and cherish with pride
the basic unity of our country. Thank you. Tejaswini Prabhu, sincere, honest, and well organized. There was a very small amount of difference between Sailesh Marks and Tejaswini, 0.01 or something.
Thank you.
तब तक आप उन्हें समझेंगे नहीं। Sincere, hardworking, and result oriented. Good organizer. Ceremony.
I request our chief guest RK Jha sir to say a few words.
And our young architects who are graduating today and will be entering into the serious career in the field. You have heard about the creation of architects. You must have also learned during your stay at the institute. I will try to give you what is your expected role in the new generation. What you have studied is the earlier one, created by somebody else. Now you will be required to do your own career. You have to carve out your own role. So my focus would be to indicate you about the as you are aware, the role of architects and planners, I combine both are Silpkar. As you progress in your career, you will not find much of difference between the architecture and planner. Both are almost same. Architects and planners are to meet the aspiration of the people. You are not doing for your own self. You are doing for somebody else to meet the aspiration of the people which is emerging today in our country. Create a structure and environment to provide quality of life. We have been dealing so far by architects, individual building, probably disregarding the surrounding around the city. But now the situation is changing. Create a conducive ecosystem for business and job opportunities. A city without business and without job opportunities is a dead city. And therefore, it is necessary that as a planner, as an architect, you have to find a balance so that not only the quality of life is available, but also a good business environment with ecosystem for business and job opportunity. And you will have a very important role in nation building. Now, what are the opportunities for you? The opportunity is abundant. It depends upon how far you are able to assert and create a job for you, for a role for you. As you know, our country is transforming, becoming a developed country in next few years' time. Economy of the country is fast growing. Cities are upgrading to provide a better quality of life and business. Residential and commercial buildings are being redeveloped. Better infrastructure is being planned. And more so, new smart town cities are being developed. Now this provides you an opportunity to play your role, to find a proper role for you, and which will come only by your efforts. Something which you have not probably thought about, that mostly you have been concentrating on buildings. But in the new generation, the infrastructure is also becoming very attractive for the architects. As you are aware, our airports are being upgraded. In fact, 75 new airports are planned to be developed in next 5 years' time. And simultaneously, existing old airports are being redeveloped. Terminal buildings are important for providing efficient service to passengers, which is very important for you. Areas surrounding the airports are being redeveloped for aerocentric facilities. When I say aerocentric facility, which are dependent upon the airport or to service the airport, like the flight kitchen, hotels, and even residential quarters for the workers. As you know, probably you might be knowing that each airport costs about 5,000 crores to 10,000 crores, depending upon the size of the airport. I'm not including the surrounding area. If you take railways, in next 5 years' time, about 200 large stations are being planned to be upgraded. Now, you might, those who have been Navi Mumbai, you must have seen Vasi Railway Station, Belapur Railway Station. I was in charge of those projects. We created in 90s with commercial complex. That's not only convenient for the people working in that area, because they don't travel involved, but it also generates substantial revenue to fund the railway infrastructure. Now, railways have taken in a very big way, and depending upon the potential of that area, about 200 large stations are being planned to be developed. One of the largest will be at Dadar station, which is expected to be about 3 million square feet. Now, all these are your potential area where you will be required to play important role. Many important stations will have integrated commercial complex. Area adjacent to stations are planned to be developed with residential, commercial, and recreational facility on TOD basis. I think you must have heard about this terminology, transit-oriented development. Because that is the most accessible area, station area is the most accessible area. So various government agencies are developing the area surrounding station, which is today very congested, to have a better environment, and that is under the TOD, self-financing TOD system. When I say highways and expressways and bridges, you may consider that what is the potential of architect in that. But that is also changing. These are planned to be safe, pleasing, and environment friendly. So a lot of architectural input is required, not only in providing the amenities or street facilities along the highways, but also landscaping in that area. The structure of such facility with aesthetically pleasing components will be required, are being done. If you have seen some of the expressways which are being done in UP and Ministry of Road and Transport, you must have seen the aesthetics which is being created there. Transport infrastructure and landscaping are being importance. This architecture, probably you might have been introduced, but you have, this is a great potential, and you have to probably, if you learn more about that, you can contribute. Besides that, along all major highways and expressways, roadside amenities are being developed, including restaurants, motels, hotels, recreational facilities, resorts. Because of the accessibility, those are very much patronized by the people. And that is one area where you will be having a lot of interest. And overall, I'm not touching the buildings, because already building the residential and commercial buildings, you have heard about that. The smart cities, there are two types of smart cities. One is brownfield smart city, another is greenfield smart city. Now both are being developed in our country. But greater emphasis from each of construction is the smart city, where the architects will have a freedom to test many of their innovations and visions, because there are not much of constraint. Brownfield, let me, existing city, you have constraint. You have other innovative interests, so you are constrained. But greenfield cities provide tremendous opportunity to create a new image for the country. So architects and planners have opportunity for innovation and creativity. I will show you a project which I was in charge. I was managing director and group CEO of GIFT City, Gujarat International Finance Tech City, which is the vision city of our present Prime Minister when he was Chief Minister. And the mandate was given to me was that this city should be planned and developed as better than the best in the world, so that we as an Indian are proud of this. And that we have tried to do it. Can you play that, AV? You will see from the visual, audio visual, that how beautiful that city is, not only beautiful, but functional, and with all the features we have. Your audio is not working?
Service sector is fast emerging as the growth engine with world-class technology, seamless connectivity, state-of-the-art infrastructure, and the finest talent pool. Analysts forecast the sector is poised to contribute up to 10 to 11 million jobs by 2020 in India. Capitalizing on this, Gujarat government is developing GIFT, Gujarat International Finance Tech City, a global financial hub. Gujarat, a preferred investment destination due to its political stability, strong leadership, pro-business policies, and vast talent pool. What's more, its intrinsic entrepreneurial spirit, backed by reliable resources and strong infrastructure, only adds to the advantage factor. The geostrategic positioning of GIFT will enable operators to service geographically extreme financial markets by bridging far-flung time zones. Accentuating the advantage factors, GIFT is located between Gandhinagar and Ahmedabad and also connected to the fastest-growing Delhi-Mumbai industrial corridor planned along the NH8. GIFT also provides easy access to the Ahmedabad International Airport via a dedicated road link. Additionally, Metro and BRTS assures access to and fro from all sides. The bird's eye view reveals the futuristic design that GIFT is. A truly international and high-tech city spread over 886 acres of land by the riverside, the master plan is divided into two zones, a notified multiple services special economic zone with processing and non-processing areas, and the remaining area as domestic tariff area, the DTA. Urban form of the city is guided by superior infrastructure. futuristic buildings, immaculate green spaces, large water body, a well-connected transport network, wide sidewalks lined by beautiful majestic trees, and a fine balance between recreational and residential spaces. In this boundaryless world at GIFT, the building blocks are planned sans boundary walls. The most picturesque public space is the Samruddhi Sarovar, a recreation lifeline of GIFT connected to Tapas Udyan, the green lung of the city, by a 60-meter wide pedestrian green boulevard. Tapas Udyan is flanked by an institutional zone that will offer world-class education and healthcare. Also, it has a fine executive golf course with clubbing facilities. GIFT boasts of one of the largest exhibition centers of India. The city will stand tall amongst its peers, recreating a dazzling skyline silhouetted against a river with Diamond Tower as its centerpiece, a 410-meter tall structure that speaks of a truly global image. Sizable foreground to the buildings and podiums will scale down the otherwise tall buildings. Facade guidelines are mandated for better orientation and natural light and ventilation. The city is being developed on smart, user-friendly, safe, eco-friendly and sustainable infrastructure principles. Multi-level car parks, metro stations, public transport hubs and elevated walkways make GIFT a pedestrian-friendly and safe city. GIFT is an eco-friendly city. It provides for 24/7 portable water supply, zero discharge aimed by reuse of wastewater, and automated waste collection system. GIFT also confirms 24/7 highly reliable uninterrupted power supply system. Cooling within GIFT is by most energy efficient district cooling system. A dedicated utility service corridor in the form of a large underground tunnel shall monitor, manage and facilitate the utility network of the entire city. Being a high-rise business district, state-of-the-art fire detection, firefighting and evacuation system is planned for GIFT. Cutting-edge ICT, smart and intelligent building and infrastructure and city command control center truly make GIFT a futuristic city. Institutional framework led by GIFT UDA will oversee the urban development and facilitate single window clearance system. GIFT CL aims to plan, develop, operate and maintain the international finance tech city through several infrastructure-led subsidiary companies. These companies will provide municipal services, advanced technology support, and focused sector-specific services to GIFT City. GIFT, a truly global financial hub, where wealth creates wealth.
And this is not imaginary. This is partly developed. I was there for 6 years from beginning, and almost 40% of the development have taken place. And I would highly recommend that all of you must visit that to get a vision of the future. There are many more things which I have not explained here. You take the, you know, solid waste management system, which is also very important for this city. Here we have got underground pipes connected to each building by two chutes, and that solid waste is sucked by vacuum, creating vacuum at 90 kilometer speed, taken to automatic segregation plant, and the metal, organic and non-organic materials are separated out. Organic material goes for composting, and inorganic goes for insertion. And there we have used a new technology that is called plasma gasification plant, where the solid waste is burned at about 3000 degree temperature, 3000 degree centigrade temperature. So you don't get any fume, no smoke, it's only ash. So this can be even located in the high density area without knowing that there is an incineration plant, which is a big headache in our cities. Many more things have been done there, which you will see that, and probably in your career, you will have an opportunity to introduce certain things. So most important is that keeping your eyes open, learning more from other experiences, and doing more innovations. Many of the things which you have seen are done for the first time in the country, not only in the country, but in the world. And this is all by Indian architects and planners and engineers. So certainly you can also do it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for a wonderful, inspirational speech. So many insights, anecdotes, and experience to give. A great perspective, not only for the profession, but also for the life in general. And yes, absolutely, looking at the GIFT City, we agree on that one, sir. One has to keep up with the latest in technology. Please give a round of applause for our chief guest, R.K. Jha, sir. Now I request our Professor Ashraf sir to give a sweet message to our alumni.
So I'd like to present a poem, like a kavita in front of you. So kavita kuch is prakar hai. Itne varshon ka saath ek jazbati rishta bana deta hai. Tumhare saath bita hua pal, aapke aur hamare dili rishte ka ek khoobsurat architecture bana deta hai. यहाँ से निकलकर आप अलग अलग रास्तों पर चले जाओगे, कुछ नई मंजिल को हासिल करेंगे तो कुछ अपनी एक नई मंजिल बनाएंगे. कामयाब रहो तुम सब, ये दुआएं दिल से निकलती है. लौटते रहना इस परिसर में, ये इस प्रांगण की मिट्टी कहती है. लौटते रहना इस परिसर में, ये इस प्रांगण की मिट्टी कहती है.
थैंक यू अशरफ सर. Now we will have vote of thanks, but before that I want to make an important announcement that after the convocation all the students are requested to return the black gowns on the counter where they have taken from, and then you can proceed for the snacks which are being served outside the auditorium. Thank you. And after that we will have the photograph session also, so I know you are waiting for that. But after vote of thanks, we will have all this. Yeah, we will have the cap throwing ceremony. Everything we will have, and class photographs we will have. But before that, I request sir to give vote of thanks.
It's been an eventful evening. Good evening, parents, friends, all the people who have made this ceremony possible. A day of mixed emotions for the students and for all of us. And as we have handed over the degrees to the three batches of the students who have passed out from the institution, dedicating further the cause of architecture. Even as there are several colleges dedicated to architecture in the city of Mumbai, our endeavor has always been to provide and allow for opportunities for students who are living nearby and in the remote places and outside the city. And we have, I believe, achieved this to the extent possible. It has been a great honor for us to have our esteemed guests who are doyens in this industry and who have shared their great insights and experiences. This, I am sure, would have inspired our students to approach the profession with the right mindset. On behalf of our college management, Principal Saju Cherian, and all the staff and students, I would like to express our deep gratitude for the presence of our special guests who have taken off time from their busy schedule and be with us. Amitji, it was a great presentation. Use of modern technologies, I believe probably there will be more factories now, manufacturing prefab components. Shivaji Patil sir, very interesting talk, especially the one on Gansoli, sports complex and auditoriums. And R.K. Jha sir, Gift City, that presentation was wonderful. I believe it's a real gift to India. Or Ashraf sir, aapne badhiya kaha, you have summed it all up. And what we found out was through the years, what stood out was the students' passion and commitment, and accordingly the awards were given, and both in academics and for the other competitions. Our best wishes again to the students to do their best and leave a mark in their careers wherever they go. Thank you all again once.
One second, goodbye.